Now we'll set up our first Orchard application. We will do it locally. So this is the scenario where you are developing your own Orchard application. First, you create it locally, you implement something, you write some code, and then later you will deploy it somewhere. And the documentation also details how you can do that, but instead of that way, we will do something a bit simpler, and that is we will use our utility scripts. The utility scripts project of Lombiq is, well, a lot of scripts that have some utility. And of course, there are a lot of scripts, well, actually two scripts related to Orchard Core, but this is supported by a lot of other scripts. And furthermore, there are a lot of other scripts for Azure, specifically for Orchard One, well, also for source control and, for example, for working with SQL Server. What we'll use now is one of the Orchard Core scripts, this one to initialize an Orchard Core solution. And if you check out the script itself, because this is also open source, you can just freely check out the source of the script too. Well, you will also find some documentation here. And well, there is also an example here that you can use as a starting point. And I will actually use this without the NuGet source parameter. The NuGet source parameter is interesting if you want to use the preview feed, but right now we'll just use the latest release version. So let's now open a folder where we'll work with the application. I have a Git repository initialized here, but you don't need to use Git or source control for that matter when you are just starting with Orchard. And I will start open a partial window here. And in this PowerShell window, I will run the script. So let's see what the script will do, and let's customize it in a way that actually suits us. First you will need to add or specify the name of your website. I will just use Dojo Course here. You can also specify the path. This is interesting if you want to create the solution under some other path that you are currently on or you are currently under. We won't need that because I will just create the solution in the current folder. And you can also automatically generate a module and a theme. Both are these Orchard plugin types. A module is more for functionality, and a theme is more for styling and look and feel. We'll look in great detail at both of these. For now, let's just create a skeleton for both of them. And well, we can also specify the module's name. Let's call it dojocourse.module. And we can also specify the theme's name. Let's call it, well, dojocourse.theme, and that's it. Now, this is, by the way, using the official templates from Orchard. So this just combines that and some of the .NET templates to initialize everything that you may need. It will take a few seconds. It will also install those templates from the internet if you don't happen to have them. For this, you pretty much need nothing to be installed apart from .NET SDK. So you have the .NET tool, the .NET command line tool available. And now that we have it, everything seems to be in working order. And as we can see in the folder, indeed everything was created. We got a solution file, which I will also open, and we have a gitignore file, which is a generally suitable ignore file for Git repositories containing such an Orchard application. And under the source folder, we have a web project and modules and themes. The web project is a pretty standard ASP.NET Core web project that initializes Orchard and fetches or includes imports all the Orchard Core packages. And we also have a modules folder, well, for all of our modules, but we only have one module currently, and we have one theme currently. This structure, by the way, is not mandatory. You can have a different folder structure, you can use different names, of course, but this is a fairly good basic start. And now let's take a look at the solution too. In the solution, we have pretty much the same structure. As you can see, we have the web project here, and we have the two projects for the module and the theme here as well, which are just pretty standard class libraries. The web project is pretty standard as well. It has a bit of configuration for Orchard. Specifically here in the startup class, we have these two Orchard initialization method calls. And we also have some configuration for the logging library and log. So let me also start it. You can also use any logging library, and while this initialized an application that is the full CMS, as we discussed earlier, you can also use just part of Orchard, not to have the full CMS, but rather run a decoupled or a headless application. I've hit Ctrl F5, so the standard keyboard shortcut to start a web application from Visual Studio, and it actually starts an IIS Express local web server and the application locally. On the first load, we will see the setup screen. And here's the setup screen. As you can see, it's fairly simple. It is also localized, so you can change languages here. And let's set up our first Orchard website. First, you have to specify the name of the website. Well, let's call it Dojo Course. Almost all of these can easily be changed later. The name of the site can be changed later too. We'll also check it out. The database to use, well, you can migrate between databases, but that's a bit harder. And the recipe is not really something that you change. So let me detail. What is a recipe here? A recipe is pretty much a JSON file, so a text file that contains content and configuration from an Orchard application. So you can use this to move content between Orchard applications, or you can use this to export the whole content and configuration of an Orchard application and use it as a template to set up new websites. And this is pretty much what also happens here. The Orchard has some built-in recipes that give you a few templates for some very common scenarios when building a web app. You can also create such recipes that will show up during the setup. So if you are a developer creating websites for multiple clients, you can use this to template your setup tasks. Recipes are very flexible, very useful. This is just a glimpse into it. Let's set up the app with the blog recipe. The blog recipe will be, well, a simple blog. It will showcase a lot of features of Orchard. That's why it's suitable now. You can also set the default time zone here, which we can also change later, but let's leave it at Budapest, because currently now I'm based in Budapest. As said, you can also change the database engine to use, or the database type. Orchard by default supports these databases. SQLite is very, very useful for development, because, you know, SQLite is just a flat file. There is nothing to set up. You just choose SQLite here, and pretty much that's it. You can also choose SQL Server, which is, of course, a full-blown database engine. You need to set up an SQL Server instance for that. And MySQL and Postgres is also available. For now, we'll just use SQLite. And then you have to set up the super user, which is, in the end, nothing really special. It's just the first user account. The Orchard, of course, has user management built in, and what you create here is the first user account that you can use to log in right after you have set up the website. This will be an administrator user account. This account will have all the permissions in the system, so you will be able to use this to configure everything later too. So, let's set it up. As the name, I will use admin. As the email, well, I will use something called something like this. And as the passwords, there are some restrictions. You can also configure these, but the default one is displayed here. I will just use password, but with a capital P, and password one, and exclamation mark. So, same thing for the configuration, and let's run the setup. I've hit enter, but of course you can also just click here under finish setup. The setup takes a few seconds, but usually it's over pretty quickly. And after that, you can see your full new website here. And well, as you can see, it is indeed a blog. It uses some theme behind the scenes. It has not just a blog, but also one blog post here that has a little bit of test content. Yeah, nothing frightening yet, nothing scary, that's just a simple template. But as I said, you can change pretty much everything that we specified on the setup screen on the admin later on too. So let's actually do that right now. And I will log in with the same admin and then password one exclamation mark here. You can get to the admin by going to slash admin. Some of the themes, some of the built-in themes also have a link to the dashboard. We also call it somewhere here in the menu. Well, not the block theme, so that's why I used used to go to the URL directly. And what we see here is the Orchard admin area, or otherwise also called the Orchard dashboard. We have quite a few options already here, and we will look at most of these in detail in later tutorials. But for now, let's check out the settings, the basic site settings here. If you open configuration here, you will get some of the settings that built-in features have. And again, under settings and general, you will see all the basic site settings. So just as an example, let's take a look at them. Here we have, again, site name, so we could change it right away. There is also the page title format, which is title as in the title tag in the HTML document. You can see it here and you can specify it. One thing to note here, just a glimpse into it, that this curious thing here is Liquid. This is a Liquid template, a piece of template code that was written in the Liquid markup language. Liquid, if you don't know it, is, well, a templating language, and it's actually a safe templating language. It was created by Shopify to provide templating capabilities for their web shops. And Orchard has full support for it. So everywhere where you have to specify some dynamic strings, like a text somewhere with some substitutions, then most possibly Liquid is used there. We can also specify the URL of the site that will be used for the basis of every link. This is only necessary if for some background processes. default time zone is again here, and then when there is paging, paging done on various admin lists, then you can specify how many items to display on a single page. So those are the basic site settings of Orchard, and as we have seen, the setup is pretty simple too. We will take a look at the admin area in later tutorials in a lot more detail. For now, this is just it. Oh, and do note that you can also hide this menu here if you want a bit more space.